ড্রাগ এবং ধরুন নিজেক অ্যান্টিকোলিনার্জিক ড্রাগস। ওকে, সো এট ফার্স্ট উই হ্যাভ টু নো অ্যাবাউট ইট। সো দেয়ার আর সো ফিউ পয়েন্ট বিফোর গোয়িং টু আদার্স, লাইক দ্য অটোনমিক নার্ভাস সিস্টেমস কনসিস্ট অফ টু ব্রাঞ্চেস, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য সিম্প্যাথেটিক অ্যান্ড দ্য প্যারাসিম্প্যাথেটিক। ওকে, অ্যান্ড দ্য অ্যাকশন অফ দ্য টু সিস্টেম জেনারেলি অপোজড ওয়ান অ্যানাদার। And this is one point. And second one is the sympathetic system is responsible for the excited state of our body, like pupillary dilatation occur as a result of sympathetic stimulation. And third one is the parasympathetic system is responsible for the body resting state. Pupillary constriction and accommodations are result of parasympathetic activities. Fourth one is neurotransmitters are chemical messenger of the nervous system. And fifth one is certain pharmaceuticals work by stimulating the mimicking or inhibiting these messenger. So this helps to manipulate the autonomic function. So these are the point that we are going to study in further slide. So if you have any query, then mention in the chat box. So before going to this, so we have to know about the what is autonomic nervous system. Okay, so the portion of nervous system that control the basal function of the body, which is known as autonomic nervous system. So this system helps to control the artery pressure and gastrointestinal motility and secretion of urinary bladder, emptiness, sweating, body temperature, and many other activities. So some of which are controlled almost entirely and some only partially by the autonomic nervous system. So these are the some points that we have to know. And one thing that the autonomic nervous system is activated in the spinal cord, brain stream, and the hypothalamus. So these are the things that I'm not going to discuss. So now let's come about the systemic division and neurotransmitter. Okay, so think of your body as a large company of organism with many divisions. So our body consists of many tissues, cells, bones, okay, and there are the many systems in our body. So it consists of large company, as we can tell. So in any such organization, a regulation agency is needed to maintain the priority or balance, or things will run amok. So if your body, the regulating agent is known as the autonomic nervous system. So it oversees the system. in your body, and the regulation agency is known as autonomic nervous system. So it oversees the body of the system of the body through two divisions. So they are known as sympathetic and parasympathetic division. So the two divisions work opposite with each other to maintain the balance. So one division causes organ to become the excited, and the other division causes it slow down. Okay, so the sympathetic nervous system is also known as the fight or flight system, because it affects are most pronounced when we are excited or find ourselves in a threatening situation. So the result of increased sympathetic activities are in rapidly pounding heart, deep spirit and breathing, and dilating pupil. the blood vessels of the skin and digestive systems are constricted, so that blood can be made more available for the heart and the skeletal muscle. So the all the functions that are not essential to immediate survival are decreased. In the word of the antinomist, Elena Marib, who was a PhD scholar, when we are running, just I'm giving one example. Like when we are running from the Mughals, it is far more important that we are your muscles be provided with every things they needed to get you out of harm away, so that you finish the digesting lunch. Conversely, the parasympathetic division is concerned with the body function. In its resting state, the main goal is to conserve energy and promote digestion. When the parasympathetic division is dominant, there is an increase in digestion. The skin is flush, pupils are constricted, and the lens of our eye accommodations for near. Though both extremes have been illustrated in actuality, the two systems work together in union to reach the harmony and equilibrium for the stress of the and the activities by the body at the same time. So the main goal is to conserve the energy and promote the digestion. So the working of the human nervous system are extremely complex. It involves many twin functions and biochemical reactions that are beyond the scope of the scope. So we will, however, examine briefly for the basic understanding. So first the brain sends a command to our muscles. A signal is sent out. The signal pass through the complex network that make up with the nervous system before arriving at a specific neurons, which is known as nerve cell, at a target muscle. This signal is responsible for the relax of the sensual biochemical, which is known as neurotransmitter, from the end of the neuron. So I'm showing the one of the picture in which you will be clear out. So these are the this is the one of the picture. Like this, this neurotransmitter cross a gap and then attack with a specific receptor. So think of the neurotransmitter is a key that fight with the specific lock, which is known as receptor. It always fight with the receptor. So these receptors are primarily located in the cardiac muscles. The smooth involuntary muscles of the internal organs and the blood vessels and certain glands. Also, there are the many glands, so it involves the certain glands. Once this attachment occurs, the original commands is then carried out. So before a new commands that can be carried out by the same muscles, the neurotransmitter must be removed from the receptor to prepare the first for the next signal. So in practice, we use the drugs to stimulate the effect of both sympathetic and the parasympathetic division to get a specific desired effect. So this can be done by the stimulating the coping or enhancing the neurotransmitter. So in additional, certain actions can be stopped by inhibiting the release of the neurotransmitter blocking. So attachment to the receptors are delaying the cleaning up process, prolonging the effect of the binding. So the major neurotransmitter of the parasympathetic divisions are epiphenyline and norepinephrine. So the drugs that mimic the effect of the sympathetic systems are known as sympathomimetic agent, also known as adrenergic agent. Phenylephrine is a drug that dilates the pupil, as we know, everyone know, and I have also discussed in other PPT. And it is one of the example of the symptomatic agent. So the drugs can also block the activities of the sympathetic systems, which are called symptolytic agent. The term lytic means breakout. Okay, so the suffix lytic refers to the breakdown of the compound, because sympathetic and parasympathetic division oppose one another and one another. So the drugs block the sympathetic systems will usually act like a drug that stimulate the parasympathetic system. If we give one example, then an example of parasympatholytic agents are beta blocker. Beta blockers is a drugs which used to control the glaucoma and help to manage the glaucoma. So the parasympathetic system use the acetylcholine and as its main neurotransmitter. Drugs that mimic the effect of acetylcholine are called parasympathomimetic or cholinergic agent. So there are also drugs that block the effect of the parasympathetic division. So these are called the parasympathomimetic agent. Like if we take an example, like, and then pilocarpine is a eye drop, another medication used to control the glaucoma, and is an example of the parasympathomimetic agent. If you take one example, then cyclopentalate is a cyclophagic agent, and it is an example of parasympatholytic or cholinergic blocking a drug. So there are several types of receptor that we bound by the neurotransmitter, and that can cause an increase in the, or decrease in function. No generalizations can explain the excitations or relaxation effect of a given neurotransmitter. So this is determined solely by the types of the receptors which is attached. For example, phenylephrine does not always cause constrictions of the blood vessels. This is determined by the types of the receptor in which it binds. Certain receptor types are found more common in certain area of the body. Like pharmacological, we know we can get desired effect if we can learn to target specific receptor sites. So the cholinergic receptors are divided into two types. One is muscarinic or nicotinic. Like adrenergic receptors are also divided into four types, first one we can say alpha 1, second one is alpha 2, and beta 1 and beta 2. So these are the cholinergic agent, and these will be deals with the more especially when it become necessary to describe a certain medications later in this. So cholinesterase is an chemical responsible for the cleaning up the neurotransmitter transmitters from its attachment to the receptors. Drugs that prevent this cleaning up are called the anti-cholinergic agent and have a sympathomimetic and parasympathetic effect. So these are the some of the drugs name. Like autonomic drugs are important in ophthalmic practice due to the multitude of the actions, and they have the like in table this. You can see the clinical use of selected ophthalmic anesthetic drugs. So these are the name of the drugs like Midiatic, which is used to dilate the pupil, like phenylephrine. We can tell, okay, like anti-glaucoma agent, which decrease the aqueous formation, like timolol, metoprolol. So these are the example of the anti-glaucoma agents, like anti-glaucoma agent which increase the aqueous outflow, like epinephrine, diprivaprine, like vasoconstrictor, whiten the eye, like phenylephrine. So these are the example. Suppose if we talk about the dilation reversible, like we can take an example of dipraprolol SCL. So these tables summarize the clinical use of adrenergic and cholinergic drugs, and though obtaining a basic understanding of the function of the autonomic nervous system, and it also effect at a certain site within the body and the eye, we can describe throughout. So the drugs will be discussed in the coming slide. Like, however, two specific autonomic drugs which do not fit into this will be discussed further. And like indropenium and autoxin botulinum drugs will be discussing in the coming slide. So if we talk about the indropenium, then so it is also known as tensilon, and it is occasionally used in ophthalmic practice to diagnose the myasthenia gravis, okay, which is a neuromuscular disease causing the progressive weakness or fatigue of the muscles. So if we talk about the eye, then in the eye, the symptoms can including dropping of the eyelid. So if the patient is complaining of dropping of the eyelid, then we can diagnose ptosis. Okay, so commonly known as tensilon test, a small amount of the indropenium is given intravenously. So if a lid drop is due to the myasthenia gravis, the drugs cause a brief improvement of the muscular strength and the lid will be elevated. So if the ptosis is not due to the myasthenia gravis, which is the one of the disease which is caused by the myasthenia gravis, so it will be unaffected by the tensilon. So indropenium is a anticholinesterase drug. So it briefly durations of activities makes it deal from a diagnostic test. So these are the name of the drugs which helps to diagnose and help. It is help for the diagnostic purpose for the testing. So side effects are uncommon, but slowly of the. So if we talk about the side effect, then it is uncommon and but slowly decrease the slowing of the heart rate and the decrease the blood pressures are possible. So indropenium chloride is available in 10 ml ampoules and vials ready for the injection. It will be a little tough for you to understand. So please, if you have any query, then please mention in the chat box. At the end, I'll be discussing. So so this is the clinical use of selected ophthalmic drug for the cholinergic agent, like Metoclopramide, pilocarpine is used, like cyclophilic. Diagnostic of myasthenia gravis, which type of drugs will be used for the paralysis of extraocular or lid muscles, which type of drugs are used for the midiatic reveals, which type of drugs are used. So this table shows given the name of the that drug. So please go through this. Now now come to the botulinum toxin. like botulinum toxin, which is commonly known as botox injection, has gained widespread use of primarily for the cosmetic and the oculoplastic procedure, as well as its limited use in the treatment of strabismus. Okay. And it is derived from the bacterial toxin, and its action arises from the blocking the release of the acetylcholine when injected directly into the targeted muscles. It causes the paralysis and relaxation of the muscles. Okay, so thus it is used to relax an overactive extraocular muscles, to stenting the eye, or to calm spasm of the eyelid. So the drug's maximal effect is noted in 1 to 2 weeks, that may be after 15 days, but the persist over and 2 to 6 month period. So it the botox injection effect will be come after 15 days, and it will long last for the 6 month, 2 to 6 month. Okay, so no systemic side effect are there, but long-term ocular alignment problems have been reported. However, transient diplopia like blepharoptosis or conjunctival hemorrhage can result from the botox injection, which is commonly known as botulinum toxin injection. So this drug is supplied as a powder that must be reconstructed in a solution for the injection. So it must be stored in a freezer below 23 degree Fahrenheit, and it is usable for the 4 hours following the reconstruction. Okay, so these are the reference from where I make this PPT. So go through this, then we will have more better idea about this all which I have been discussed. So thanks for your attention. If you have any query, any question, then please ask. So any of you having any query regarding this lecture? I know many of you couldn't understand. आप लोगों को समझ में आया कुछ?
सर ये botulinum toxin का बता दिया सर. botox injection तो मतलब स्किन में लगता है ना, वो झुर्री आना पड़े जिसकी वजह से जो होता है.
स्किन में लगता है means?
सर मतलब वो होता है ना, कैसे बताऊं सर, जैसे सुकड़ जाते हैं, स्किन सुकड़ जाती है तो वो फेस पे लगता है सर इंजेक्शन.
एक डिजीज रहता है ना जैसे ब्लेफारोस्पाज्म, जो एनी टाइम ब्लिंक करते रहते हैं. देखो ये पेशेंट को जब एनी टाइम वो ब्लिंक करते
बार-बार ब्लिंक करते
बार-बार ब्लिंक करते रहते हैं वो, और मेनली फोटोफोबिया का कंप्लेन करते हैं. तो डॉक्टर रमन क्या करते हैं, बोटस इंजेक्शन देते हैं ना हम लोग का यहाँ आंख में, यहाँ पर जैसे यहाँ पर देते हैं डायरेक्टली, इधर देते हैं, इधर देते हैं, इधर देते हैं. तो जहाँ पर इंजेक्शन देते हैं ना वहाँ पर मार्क करते हैं वो कौन कौन सा ये प्लेस में वो कौन सा एरिया कवर किया है इंजेक्शन के थ्रू. डोसिस में भी देते हैं. मैंने यहाँ पर तुम लोग को नाम बताया ना कि किस में हम लोग दे सकते हैं, like transient diplopia दे सकते हैं, blepharoptosis में भी दे सकते हैं, subconjunctival hemorrhage में भी दे सकते हैं. तो ये सब में थोड़ा ज़्यादा अच्छा काम करते हैं, रिजल्ट अच्छा आता है, बहुत लिटरेचर वगैरह सब देखा है. और जो ये ड्रग्स का इफेक्ट आता है ना 15 दिन के बाद ही आता है, और ये किसी किसी को 2 महीना तक 6 महीना तक लॉन्ग लास्टिंग रहता है. ये परमानेंट इलाज नहीं है, पर टेम्पोररी इलाज है.